अस्सलाम वालेकुम, वेलकम बैक। आज हम डिस्कस करेंगे मोटिवेशन के कॉन्सेप्ट, मोटिवेशन कॉन्सेप्ट टू एप्लीकेशंस। ऑलराइट, हम इसमें ये डिस्कस करेंगे कि मोटिवेशन की जो मुख्तलिफ थ्योरीज हमने पिछले लेक्चर में पढ़ी, हम उसको किस तरीके से ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल सेटिंग में अप्लाई कर सकते हैं। लेट्स मूव टू द लेक्चर। इस टॉपिक के अंदर, इस डिस्कशन लेक्चर के अंदर हम बेसिकली जानने की कोशिश करेंगे जॉब करेक्टरिस्टिक मॉडल क्या होता है और इसमें क्या इंग्रीडियंट्स होते हैं या क्रिटिकल फैक्टर्स होते हैं या एलिमेंट्स होते हैं, उसके बारे में हम समझेंगे। और जॉब रीडिजाइन किस तरीके से की जा सकती है विद इन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, और एम्प्लॉय प्रोग्राम जो है, एम्प्लॉयज इन्वॉल्वमेंट प्रोग्राम है, उसके बारे में समझेंगे। और पे स्ट्रक्चर के बारे में जानने की कोशिश करेंगे, ठीक है। एंड आफ्टरवर्ड्स हाउ टू रिवार्ड द परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ द एम्प्लॉयज, ऑलराइट, एंड व्हाट काइंड ऑफ अ फ्लेक्सिबल बेनिफिट्स दैट एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन कैन ऑफर टू देयर एम्प्लॉयज, ऑलराइट, एंड व्हाट आर मोस्ट सिग्निफिकेंट फैक्टर्स दैट आर एक्चुअली यू नो मेन कास्ट टू द एम्प्लॉयज मोटिवेशन, जस्ट लाइक intrinsic reward or extrinsic reward, all right? तो हम discuss करेंगे इसी lecture के अंदर। Job characteristic model में पांच बड़े की जो है dimensions होती हैं, जिससे में skill variety है, task identity है, task significance है, autonomy and feedback। Skill variety, what does it mean by the skill variety? Skill variety that means a degree to which the job incorporates a number of different skills and talent, all right? I mean that is very important. Any employee who is working within the department or an organization, he should have a kind of a you know variety of the task, all right, where he should use his multi skills. It may be the writing skills, maybe communication skills, I mean maybe analytical skills, conceptual skills, all right. These are multi skills that employee should be able to use while doing his job. I mean this is a job of the employer or the department manager to design the job of an individual or employee in a way that he should be able to utilize all his skills, all right, while doing his job. Kyunki uske andar when employee do the same kind of a thing with a less you know utilization of his skills, it will create a monotonous you know kind of a job, and it will eventually cause to the boredom. All right, so it's very important that your employer for the employer for the HODs to design a job or assign a task to the individual or employee in a way that he should be able to utilize his skills that he or she has. Task identity, when a job is assigned to the employee, he should have a feel that this task is completed by him. I mean it should be traceable enough that employee should feel that he or she has completed his task. It should be identifiable, it should be you know it can be seen that this is task which is completed by this employee X, employee Y, employee Z, all right. That is very important that whenever employee perform any task, he always have a feeling that it's his or her job should be noticed, all right. Then it comes to the task significance. I mean, and this is a psychology of a you know employee, that an employee working within the organization, he feels sometimes he you know try to identify what kind of contribution he or she is actually doing within the organization or department functions, all right, and what kind of a contribution he is actually giving to the society. I mean that again depend upon the you know job function a particular employee performs within the organization, but again that is the significance of that particular task or a job is very important. It should employee should feel that his you know job which is being performed by him or her actually makes a lot of contribution within the you know progression within the progress for the progress of the department or in the organizations, all right. Then autonomy, employee should feel liberty to perform his task with his own you know authority. He should have authority to perform tasks in his own way. He should be able to you know amend the procedures, he should be able to you know change the you know take a decision to perform his task effectively. I mean that is very important. Sometimes you might have seen the different SOPs, standard operating procedures within the organization. I mean it also ranging from the you know low to the big multinational firms. It is very pertinent to understand for the employer that so much so you create a strict standard operating procedures, it actually reduces the autonomy of an employee to take a flexible decision, take a decision on his own. I mean that brings a monotonous sense, a monotonous kind of a work, all right, that really creates a lot of boredom, because employees who having a lot of skills can utilize their skills while performing the task and can bring a lot of efficiency with their work processes. But because of the standard operating procedures, employees have a less liberty to take their actions on their own, and that is the only reason that employees usually get boredom and become so much disengaged, because they don't feel any charm or any attraction within their job. All right, that is very important. You should at least design a task, or you should set a procedure that may allow employees to take a decision whenever required. I mean, it's also part of a conflict management process. Employee need to be flexible enough that he or she may take a decision on his own based on his own skills and wisdom, so that a proper or a good result can, or a high result can be achieved. Feedback, that is very important for the HOD and the employer to provide a continuous feedback to the employees, whether they are up to the mark, they are lagging in some performance criteria, and they are, if they are extraordinary people, they should be rewarded accordingly. I mean, feedback is very critical, because if you don't give them a feedback, it may, you know, take them to the wrong direction. It is very critical to provide them a feedback, because they should know that they are working in the right direction, and which is eventually contributing to the achievement of the organizational goal. All right. Now, let's say we actually try to, you know, expand this job characteristics model through this graph. I mean, as we discussed, core job dimension or skill variety, task identity, task significance, autonomy, and feedback. And what these critical dimensions actually have an impact on the human psychology or employee psychology. It basically creating, it has a very critical psychological, you know, impact. For example, when you provide or you give a kind of a job to the employees having a skill variety, where employees feel a task identity and task significance, and that way they actually realizes that their experience, their experiences, their contribution are meaningful to the work. I mean, they are actually positively contributing within the organization. All right. When you give them a responsibility, they feel a sense of responsibility. When you give them autonomy, they actually feel the sense of responsibility, and kind of ownership is created within the minds of the employees, because they know that they are authorized and they are actually made responsible for their own performance, their own work. If their work is substandard, their performance will also be affected, and their impression and their evaluation will also be impacted, all right, or affected. So for that matter of fact, employees will feel a sense of responsibility. He will try to own his own job. He will put himself 100% to perform tasks efficiently and effectively, to maximum contribute to achievement of the departmental goals or the organizational goals. All right. Then keep knowledge of actual results. I mean, when feedback comes in a two way, like one comes through the annual performance appraisal system, which resulted such eventually comes through the reward system, and one is a continuous feedback system. All right, I mean, that is very important that you need to give that you need to give feedback to the employees to set their direction in a proper way, and to give them a very true and very rational feedback. If they are lacking in some skills, if they are lacking some job attributes, you need to give them a very true advice, so that they can make up with it and they can contribute effectively within the organization. All right. And what all these psychology states, psychological states of, employee results in outcome. All right. And that is, when there is a positive psychology of an employee, of course, it will lead to the positive performance of the employee. All right. How high work motivation. All right, high quality performance and satisfaction, lower turnover. When you are engaged, when you are motivated with your work, all right, you are motivated from your work, you are very much committed, involved within your job that is assigned to you by your HOD, head of the department, or an organization or employer, you always have a high motivation, because you have a sense of ownership, sense of loyalty, sense of commitment, and sense of eagerness. You always try to do something better for the organization. Eventually it results in high performance, because you work hard, you really focused, and you always try to adopt things that are very much cost effective, efficient, and can result in a great performance to the organization. All right. When you are engaged, of course, when you are satisfied, when you are feel comfortable, when your job is secure, you are respected, you are valued, your work is highly recognized, then of course you will less likely to leave that kind of organization where you and your work is respected. And this is a basically employee growth criteria or employee career path. I mean, when you provide such kind of a thing, a skill variety, autonomy, and feedback, it always leads to a positive impact on the employees' psychology and their outcome and overall organizational performance. It is very pertinent for the organization or employer or the HOD, you need to redesign the jobs. Rotation is also part of it, all right? You need to review your job functions. You need to review the job functions of the employees. You need to review the work processes of your department. You need to review the standard operating procedures that are prepared. You need to keep on updating all these things, all right? Because stagnancy is nowhere better for organization or the employees equally, all right? So you should not be stagnant in any way. Standard operating procedures are made for the people, people are not made for the SOPs, all right? You need to keep on improving your SOPs. You need to keep on review yourself, all right? That is very important. And how you can do it, there are some strategies or a method that is job rotation. You need to keep on changing. An average within the industry that is more, 3 to 4 years more than enough. If an employee is working continuously for past 3 to 4 years on a particular job, it is more than enough and you need to rotate it. I mean, you might have observed different employees working in a particular department for past many years, for past almost 10, 15 years, and sometimes people in our society, Pakistani organization, people hired in a particular job are retired, are retired sometimes, all right, from the same level of positions. I mean, job rotation is very important. Let me tell you an example of a multinational company. I used to work in a kind of a automotive company that was a Japanese-based, origin company. And the part of their strategy was like they used to keep on rotating different people from bottom to top. Even, divisional head and general manager and director levels were used to be rotated because their objective was to give them a feeling that they can be used and their potential can be utilized anywhere in the department, all right? And this is something that gives them energy to the employees, and they try to utilize their skills, wisdom, and knowledge, skills, abilities for the best performance of the that particular department or the organization. So you need to shift employees from one department to another to another, all right? Job rotation is very important. The time period is around like 3 to 4 years more than good enough, all right? Job enrichment, the expansion of job by increasing the degree to which the worker controls the planning, execution, and evolution of their work, all right? I mean, you need to give them a little space so that they may able to take decision by their own. I mean, they should, redesign the task. They should, you should give them a, power, authority, liberty to take a decision by their own. I mean, that is a job enrichment. It's also known as a job empowerment, all right? When you are empowered to make a decision about your own task, you are likely to take a decision that are more suitable for you and the organization alike, all right? What is the best what are the benefits of the job rotations? I mean, it helps manager in scheduling, all right? And reduces the boredom, increase understanding of work contribution, and increase skills. I mean, when you are rotated from one department to another, of course, to perform your task within another department, you need to learn some additional skills. For example, if an employee is working in the finance department and he was doing a payroll job or a taxation job, and he would have been a kind of a required skills, like he may be very good at taxation. But when he's rotated and transferred to the HR department, for that matter of fact, he might need some additional skills to perform the task within the HR department, for instance, like communication skills, say, for instance, like recruitment skills, all right? Recruitment strategy he might need to learn. And again, a behavioral training or interview skills may require for that employee. So in order to perform his or her task, definitely he would have to go through the all training process. He would have to learn and upgrade his required skills to perform that particular task. It enables employees to become a multi-skilled person, the person who is actually can be a person can be utilized in the finance and the HR department alike. I mean, they are genuinely and real assets for the organization because they are kind of a people who can work in within any environment. That is the big reason why organization actually looking for the people or an individual who are actually team player. And he or she must have at least ability to communicate and coordinate with other departments or other colleagues, with ease. All right. Now, job enrichment. What are the possible actions? You can combine different tasks together so that employee or can feel at ease, and he should be able to learn new skills. And again, once he learns, and he or she can utilize his skills to perform his tasks. All right. Formal natural work units. I mean, you need to find out the similarity within the task. It is not recommended at all. A person who has good at writing, a person who might need to work within the office environment, and at the same time you give him a task which is actually a field work. I mean, you need to align the different tasks together and on a similar features. All right. Establish client relation. I mean, when you deal with the employees, it is very important for the HODs, the employers, I mean the people who manages the staff, that they should have a employee and client relationship within the department. All right. And this is a kind of a skill, or what we say, persuasive skills, and the assertive skills is very much crucial for each and every person working within the organization, that he should have a sense and ability to establish a client relationship within the colleagues, within the department, and outside your organization as well. Expand job vertically, all right? I mean, that is very important. When you expand a job or a task of an employee, that is important, you need to bring all related matters under the umbrella. All right. You cannot, expand the job horizontally. You need to expand the job vertically. For example, if a person who is working actually on the, recruitment side, he is a recruitment specialist. You need to, expand his job by like screening, by application screening. All right. Where you campus recruitment can be part of it. And, job hunting can be part of it. Even social hiring can be part of it. I mean, this is a kind of a vertical integration or a vertical expansion of a particular task. Open feedback channels. You need to have a different feedback channels within the department or within the organization. I mean, there are many organizations who actually uses the different techniques and methods to evaluate the performance of an individual, including a 360 degree as a, evaluation criteria, where every employee is expected to maintain a good and healthy and cordial relationship within the department, within the colleagues, HODs, seniors and the peers, subordinates and their superior authorities. I mean, their performance is being evaluated by each and every one of them. All right. Again, there are depending upon the that wholly depend upon the organization nature of work and the organization you are working in and the environment you have to adopt, different performance appraisal methods, because this is not necessary that 360 degree appraisal system may work everywhere in the organization. All right. Now, employee involvement, we need to understand what is it and how can we actually make sure that the employees are involved within the organization, because involvement is very important. Without employee involvement, you might not have a, required performance input, required performance output, and you might miss the targets at the end of the month or at the end of the annual appraisal system, appraisal period, all right? And for that matter of fact, you need to make sure that employees is completely engaged. He's totally involved. He feels so secure in the organization. He feels safe while suggesting anything. What are the possible, ways or methods to make sure that employees are involved within the task within the organization? And that is one of the methods is participative management. I mean, there are many organizations where, collective decisions are made. I mean, it depends upon the nature of task from low to the maximum decision. I mean, decisions are taken in a collective environment. All the departmental heads are, all the departmental heads, sit together and make a decisions. All right. Again, I would like to quote an example of a different Japanese company. This is a part of their culture that they usually make a decision collectively. I mean, every opinion is being respected. Different recommendation and suggestion is started, is required or is, brought to the table for the little debate and discussions. And afterwards, when consensus is developed, they usually take a decision. All right. Representative participation. Goals is to redistribute power over councils or a board representative. This is normally happens within the large organization. I mean, an organization where different unions are involved. I mean, there are different, you know, representatives out there. I mean, say for instance, I mean, you can take an example of a different multinational companies. They always try to have a representation from each and every work of the employment side. All right, it may be the job contract worker, it may be the permanent worker, it may be the, you know, lower management staff, it may be the higher management staff. All right, every segment of the employee, every fragmentation or every, you know, corner of every you know, different, every type of employees are being represented while making any decisions. All right, they used to recommend the people, they jointly select or elect the people who can represent their, you know, interest, their discussions, and their, you know, different feedback can be achieved from this approach. And this is again, you know, this is one of the way, one of the method to bring all together and to get their participation or involvement in the decision making criteria. Now, afterwards, using rewards to motivate employees, what is the way forward? I mean, these are different techniques that actually helps employer to keep their employees motivated. And again, reward is has a great and critical and crucial, you know, role in the motivation of the employees. So what are those, you know, factors actually that drive a job satisfaction or employee motivation? All right. First of all, employer need to make sure that they are having a very updated and proper pay structure. All right. They are compatible to the market. They are compatible within the industry, and they are quite compatible that they can hold a productive and, you know, performing employees within the organization. Now, for matter of fact, you need to have a different, you know, structures within the organization, within the single organization, all right? Variable pay programs is also part of that, you know, reward system. So we will understand and during this presentation that what is a variable pay programs, establish a pay structure, how it is actually prepared or pay structure is designed, all right? Pay structure, when you develop a pay structure for an organization, you need to consider two main important things. One, internal pay equity. I mean, job evolution is more important. I mean, what kind of input, what kind of, you know, efforts, inputs, you know, that particular employee is performing, all right? And you need to evaluate that job within the organization, that how this other departmental employees or staff is being evaluated and rewarded. Say for instance, a person who is working as an assistant manager human resource and the another person who is working as an assistant manager finance, you need to evaluate what is their, you know, I mean, what is, what kind of a job requirement, what job skills are required to perform the task of human resource, and what skill set is required to perform the task of finance. You need to evaluate. You need to evaluate that if these both jobs are equally important and set on an equal rating scales, then it is known as a, you know, a job evaluation. You need to evaluate that how actually this, and you need to reward that particular level of you know, their performance based on the evaluation. If they are on the same level, you need to perform. You need to reward them equally. If something is higher, I mean, say for instance, employee A is higher than the employee B in terms of their, you know, level of input and the level of criticality of the job, you need to reward them higher than the as compared to the employee B. And again, now another factor is also important, that is external pay equity, means you need to compare those pay structure within the industry. For example, if AM human resource or manager HR is drawing, say for instance, 300,000 rupees in your organization, you need to evaluate that whether this kind of job, this, you know, is being paid. You need to assess how other organization is paying to the HR managers, all right? You need to compare your pay structure with other industries. I mean, outside your organization, maybe within the industry, maybe outside the industry. Of course, it will help you. It will, you know, help you to redefine and restructure your pay system. All right, it doesn't mean it does not mean at all that you actually get influenced, because every organization has a different environment, different financial position, different circumstances, and different skill task is required. All right, even within the industry, say for instance, if you are working within the pharmaceutical company, and you need to compare, and if you are all different factors actually helps an organization to design their pay structures. Therefore, while comparing your pay structure with the other organization, may it be part of your industry or outside your industry, you need to assess different angles, different dimensions of the organization. And once you evaluate it, and once you feel comfortable, and when you decide that, okay, say for instance, organization B is equally operating on the same level as you are, then you need to compare that pay structure with their pay structure as well. And you need to find out whether you are at good position or you are lagging behind. You need to compare it, because it will also help you to reduce the turnover. I mean, say for instance, if organization B is, you know, paying higher salaries than yours, then it is likely that your employees may, you know, leave your organization, try to join or to become a part of another organization, which again will be a matter of concern for your organization. All right. Therefore, these two things are very much important: internal pay equity and external pay equity. What are likely variable pay programs? Every organization may design according to their requirement, their requirement of the business. I mean, these are the possible, you know, different variable, pay system that can be adopted by the organization. That is the piece rate pay. I mean, it is normally adopted by the textile sectors. All right. I mean, the number of output that you produce on a particular day or hour, you are being compensated accordingly. All right. There is a piece rate means depending upon the number of units that you actually produced. All right. Merit-based pay system is again a performance appraisal system. If you are being rated as an A high performer, your compensation, your pay and packages or increments will significantly be higher than the rest of your employees working on your same batch or same band. Bonuses, one's performance, because when you talk about the bonuses, again, it is depends upon, you can also, you know, bring a little flexibility in there. You can create different criteria, bonus bands. You can also say that just like a salary bands, you also created bonus bands as well. I mean, depending upon the temporary workers, permanent workers, management staff, you can have a variety of the bonuses. I mean, criteria, you can define a different criteria for all these categories of the job. All right, like this is happening within the industry, because when bonuses are announced, they are basically linked to the performance criteria. All right, and criteria being set by the organization are varied. I mean, that depends upon the level of performance, your behavior, your attendance, your punctuality, your discipline, your completion of the goals or task completion. All right. These are different criteria may be set forth for the, you know, performance evaluations. Once they are rated and being graded as an A, B, C, you can have a different bonus amount for a different categories of employees. All right. A skill based system. I mean, there are a job who are basically, you know, very critical, and they require a very sophisticated skills. For that matter of fact, you might need to, you know, compensate those skills as well, and employees are being rewarded higher than the normal one. All right. Skill based means a kind of a, you know, critical skill that is a very crucial for your organization or a task to perform. All right. Say for instance, if I say, in finance, you need to have a person who is very much, you need to have a person who is good at, you know, like taxation. I mean, it's a very specialized skills, all right? Or a crane operator is a very specialized skills. These are certain skills, and depending upon the, you know, scarcity of the skills, they are also being rated accordingly. I mean, skill-based pay, if you are a kind of a person having a high skills, say, for instance, if you are a head of HR, you are certified human resource professional, and you have a different certification, international certification, then definitely these skills will add value. All right, these skills will be compensated by the organization, because you have got extraordinary skills that are not actually available with other employees. All right, now profit sharing plans. Once a company is in a profitable situation, employers should actually have a good profit sharing plans. Maybe like you need to share your profits, all right, by giving them some extra bonus, extra pay, 1 month pay, or anything, any plan that you can actually have that. It is the purpose of this profit sharing plans is that if your organization, you encourage or motivate your employees, if their performance is high, remains high during the particular performance period, definitely, and the organization earns profit, and then surplus amount will also be shared within the employees. Gain sharing, when you have a surplus amount and you might have a, you know, like a different stock options, all right? You can offer different stock options to the different employees, all right? And you can also have a, you know, gain sharing. You can offer gain sharing to the employees. If supposedly if organization is you know, getting or earning 10% profit, you can actually have some share of those employees or a segment of the employees in a, you know, this your organization's profitability. So these are different variable pay program. I mean, commission is also variable pay programs. You can also add a commission in it, all right? You can also add an incentive in it. You can also add in a, you know, non-monetary benefits in it. These are the different, you know, variable pay programs where you actually compensate employees to keep them motivated. All right, this is again, as I said, we have a little overview of it. In piece rate pay, pays a fixed sum of money for each unit of production completed. All right, this is a very fixed merit-based system, pays for individual performance based on performance appraisal results. If appraisals are designed correctly, workers performing at high level will get more pay. All right, bonuses pay a lump sum at the end of a designated period of a time based on individual or organizational performance, as I said. Now, skill based is what is it? Pays based on the number of skills employee have. All right, as I said, I mean, if you are multi, you have a variety of skills, certification, and core competence skills, you definitely be compensated higher than the rest of the employees. Profit sharing pays out a portion of the organization profitability. It is an organization-wide program and is based on the predetermined formula. Say, for instance, you generally announce 3% profit will be shared to the employees, and everybody will be, you know, getting the 3% ratio of their salary in you know, in a particular month. All right, gain sharing pays for improvement in group productivity from one period to another. All right, and it is a group incentive plan. In fact, I remember one example of it. I was working in an automobile factory when our company actually achieved a 1 million target, you know, of a production of, you know, automobile units in a particular period. And, you know, different suites were distributed among different employees, all right, all the employees, in fact. So this is, you know, I mean, a kind of incentive that you give, you can give them a different kind of, you know, incentive that you can plan for them. Employees' stock ownership plans provides each employee with the opportunity to acquire stock as a part of their benefit packages. So there are, these are a certain, you know, different variable pay programs. Flexible benefits, a benefit plan that allows each employee to put together a benefit package individually tailored to her own needs and situation. Normally it happens, I mean, employees' needs are varied from person to person, all right? I mean, say, for example, if somebody is needing, you know, maternity benefit or coverage, hospital coverage for their spouse, I mean, another employee might need another thing, all right? I mean, that is very important. Let's talk about like medical coverage, like hospitalization or OPD for their spouse. I mean, there, if we talk about the youngster employees who just graduated and employed in an organization, they are less interested in the, you know, hospitalization and the OPD for their spouse, because they are usually unmarried at the age of like 25 years or 26 years, all right? And they are more, you know, inclined towards the financial benefits rather than the hospitalization and other things, all right? But again, this plan enables organization to have a flexibility in designing different, you know, benefits programs so that different kind of needs of employees can be addressed altogether. I mean, if say, for instance, depending upon the nature and the, you know, demographic employment status of the you know, organization, if say, for instance, the organization having a, you know, people under the age of like 25 years or 30 years, they are less likely to, you know, be attracted on the hospitalization or OPD benefits. Rather, they would be more motivated if you are actually paying them a you know, cash or a salary on a monthly basis. So they will be highly motivated if you are paying them a higher salary. So these are the things that an organization or a HOD need to see that. All right, employees recognition program. There are multiple different, you can have a newsletter, all right, within the organization to recognize the performance of the employees, that he has achieved the target, monthly target. It's normally happened in the insurance industry. Insurance organization usually do, if an employee achieve their monthly or a weekly or a, you know, yearly targets, they are their efforts and they are being recognized. They are recognized within the organizations. I mean, then name is being displayed on the notice board of the organization. Their names are being printed in the usually printed in the newsletters. They are being given a different incentives. They are additional holidays. I mean international tours. These are different kind of a program that can be a part of a employee recognition program and enable organization to recognize the contribution and efforts of an employee within the organization. All right, these are the people who are actually high performer, and it is very common in the pharmaceutical industry. I mean pharmaceutical industry, every individual from sales representative to the GM sales, they are highly competent people who are actually generate the sales within the very tough kind of environment, and they are being recognized very heavily as well. All right, and apart from that, like this is again a kind of a different recognition program, and like there are two other approaches as well. Like for example, intrinsic reward and extrinsic reward. When I say intrinsic reward, that employee should feel happy when he do something good. I mean, it is very important that he should be given a respect. He should have some happiness from the inside. I mean, whether you are paying them a monetary benefits or a non-monetary benefits, even you appreciate them. I mean, when your boss or your employee, your MD, CEO, when appreciate someone, definitely it creates a cause of a motivation within the employee. They definitely gives a very positive vibe to the employees. I mean, they become self-motivated. They become motivated from the inside. As to employee recognition from a good method, intrinsic reward includes rewards can range from a simple thank you to more widely publicized formal program. Financial incentives are more motivating in short-term advantage. They are inexpensive and effective. Some critics say they can be politically motivated if they are perceived to be applied unfairly. I mean, criticism always does exist. So you need to have a different approaches while recognizing, while having an employee recognition program within the organization. But the most important factor in this employee recognition program is you have to have a sincerity. What you do, you should mean it. All right. Thank you very much. आज के लेक्चर में इतना ही, और अगले लेक्चर में मज़ीद डिस्कस करेंगे किसी नए कॉन्सेप्ट के साथ. Thank you so much.